it's not up to me what the governor's going to do. He's threatened to veto that, so that means I'm going to freeze my tracks and cast what I think is right aside? Absolutely not. My model for this whole approach here is based off of reality and history. If you think back to William Wilberforce, the Minister of Parliament, in the 18th and 19th century in England, he took on single-handedly the slave powers. They had the money, they had the industry. Sounds familiar here, doesn't it? And he was mocked, ridiculed, he was called a traitor. He was best friends with Thomas Jefferson during the American Revolution, corresponding with an enemy of the state. And you can imagine how he must be a Republican. They called him a Republican. I call that a badge of honor. But his persistence, and this cost him his life. He was so passionate about this issue that every year he introduced legislation. And slowly the people across Great Britain and the United Kingdom, their eyes were open to the immorality and unjust approach to slavery. And one of the cases made by William Wilberforce every year with the legislation was that, hey, the sugar you use in our teas comes from Jamaica. That sugar cane is melted in a pit where slaves, black slaves, are falling in and being burned alive. And so there was a movement across Great Britain and the United Kingdom to stop using sugar, and they went to honey. And he had this movement of the next generation of people that were more anti-slavery than his generation. That's what we're seeing here today. Our persistence, we have to fight the good fight. You know what, we're not going to win any victories if you capitulate. And that's one problem with many of us on this side of the issue. And you can grow weary. We've been trying. We've heard so many promises. You campaign, you speak all these truths and how you're going to fight, and then when it's time to stand up, well, you know, the governor's not going to pass it. I refuse to surrender. As somebody who served 30 years in the United States Army, facing foes in Iraq and Afghanistan, standing against Ivan on the Iron Curtain, I'm going to fight this to my dying breath, because this is a fight worth fighting, and I'm going to fight to the end.